the trooper. Yo, 4:13 in the p.m. on a Tuesday. Time to get this iced coffee going and get the hell out of here. Lady Trooper's out at the town square, somewhere like that. Where should we go today, y'all? I'm hyper. I don't know why. I blame Iron Maiden. I'm telling you, I blame Iron Maiden. Yep, you see it back downtown. Golden Nugget action again. They only have one game right now, which is a little strange, but it is Tuesday at 5:29 p.m. So I guess we'll see how this goes. You know, I'm impatient. I don't like to wait for a seat. I do got to go get some food first, though, because I don't think this is going to do it. I really don't like to do too much in this Groundhog Day action. Same place over and over. I almost went to the Orleans, because people are always like, Trooper, won't you play at the Orleans? And they do have like 13 games. I don't know how many, no limit. It's seems like just yesterday it was getting dark at 4:30 p.m. It's 5:30 p.m. and it's still daylight. I don't know if the sun is actually below the horizon yet, but what's this dude doing? What's he doing? Shooting a damn movie or something? This dude shooting a movie? Sir, what you shooting? Sir, you shooting a movie? Or is that the news? That might be the news, I don't know. One of my favorite things in downtown Vegas are those type of lights that are underneath that awning, like over the walkway, over the sidewalk. Love them. Why do I love them so much? I don't know, but I love them. You know what's funny? I used to gamble, you know what I mean? I used to take the worst of it and enjoy it. And there was that David versus Goliath thing, you know what I mean? That was, I don't know, that felt good, you know, going into the casino, trying to play like blackjack or craps or video poker or something like that to try to get the best of the casino somehow, just to try to win, to beat David. And it's funny because when I think about things like those kind of lights right there, and I'm thinking about a tweet that I saw yesterday from Twitter account Don't Lose All of It. The name is Count Everything. I'm not going to say your real name. I know who you are. Shout out to that guy. Yesterday he put up a poll on Twitter that said, does Vegas still seduce you? I answered yes, but it looks like 60% of the people said no. 60 something percent said no, and 30 something percent said yes. It's just funny because it does. I mean, it is different at the moment, very different. And of course, it's always different. It's always changing, but no matter how much it changes, or no matter how many masks they want you to wear, it does still seduce me. It doesn't seduce me into doing things I don't want to do, like, you know, gambling in the casino, but there is something romantic about walking around, you know, the especially downtown Fremont Street. All right, I'm gonna find some food. Brisket action going. Yo, that damn brisket sandwich is good. Why is it always gotta be so loud up here? Oh, I thought I heard somebody yell at me. I thought I heard someone say trooper. Yo, the brisket sandwich is good. I don't know if you can hear me, but that shit's good. I ran into a little turbulence early in the session so far. Started out with aces, heads up to the flop. Queen 10, 5, 2 hearts. He checks, I bet. He calls. Turn card, 3 of clubs. He checks, I bet 25. He calls. River ace. He leads out for 30. Obviously, I just call. King Jack, obviously that's what he has, but what are you gonna fold a set of aces on the river for 30 bucks? Then, ace queen in a straddle pot, out of position. I decide to play it kind of slow because of who I'm in the pot with. I'm the small blind. Folds around to me, I call with ace queen. Big blind calls. Straddler makes it 15, I call, big blind calls. The flop is queen 6-7 rainbow. I check, check. Straddler bets 20. I call 20. Big blind calls 20. Turn card 9. I lead out for 50. Big blind calls. Straddler folds. River card is an ace. Top 2. Of course, I'm concerned about 8-5. The dude shouldn't have 8-5, but he could have 8-5. So I lead the river for 70. He thinks about it for a long time and he finally calls and says, I got the bottom in. Good hand, 5-8. No big deal, down a couple hundred now. But I really want a coffee. So let's see if the D has their coffee joint still open right now. Situation from Jackpots. It's called a Frigo. It's cold brew coffee and heavy cream and vanilla syrup blended with ice. It tastes okay. So I got good news and bad news about that coffee run. The bad news is about the coffee. The good news is about the run. Holy shit, what's with all the popo? Damn, calling all cars. So the bad news about the coffee run is that the coffee did end up tasting sour. I only drink about a third of it. It wasn't good. Like the back of my throat, I just drank coffee with heavy cream, vanilla syrup blended with ice. And the back of my throat is like I ate some lemon heads. But the good news about the coffee run is that within about four hands, maybe six hands after I got back from the coffee run, I was even. Cause I was stuck 270 or something like that. So I end up winning $35 for the night. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos. That's right, I said it. Tell your friends about the videos. And leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.